Hi, this is Josh Stern.
And Michael Walters.
With the Millionaire Agent Mindset Tip for you. So I've been selling real estate now for over 15 years, and my team and I have sold over 2,000 homes along the Wasatch Front. I'm also a Mega Agent Productivity Systems Coach for some of the top real estate teams in the world, and I am focused on helping you to achieve your own greatness potential. So we're gonna do a 12 series coaching video on the shifting market. And these techniques, when applied, will actually cause your business to thrive in a shift or thrive in any market. So take a look at why millionaire agents look forward to the shift. Today we're gonna talk about the final tactic millionaire agents deploy in a shifted market. This one is super important. It's all about bulletproofing the transaction, which means getting ahead of issues and providing solid solution. When Abe Lincoln was asked what he would do if he had 8 hours to chop down a tree, he responded, "I'd spend 6 hours sharpening my axe." You see, forewarned is forearmed. This means that we have to educate our clients. We must tell our buyers and sellers what to expect. It keeps the drama out of the transaction.
There are really six bulletproofing transaction issues that we're going to touch on. Number one, inspections and appraisal repairs. Things can go wrong because they may be unexpected findings, inspection report complexities, confusion about cost and who pays what. And there are also timetables for repairs, and certainly following that is simply doubt about the house's worthiness.
Oh, doubt, we see that all the time. We focus on setting up expectations up front for both buyers and sellers. Often we'll have our sellers get their homes pre-inspected before they go on the market. It may be a good idea to actually attend the home inspection with the buyer or the seller, because we might want to have some pre-negotiated limits on inspection repairs. We always help select and supervise the vendors based upon track record and quality. And then we're really helping prepare and reassure buyers throughout the entire process.
Appraisals can also be an issue, especially in a downward trending market when the appraisal doesn't support the contract price or won't support the loan type. And sometimes the condition of the home can present issues. In these cases, you really want to provide appraisers the research up front, as well as help buyers find additional funds to close on the loan, and of course negotiate with the seller and the lender for funds. Or if it doesn't match your valuation, you can ask for an appraisal appeal.
Okay. Loan approvals and funding can show up as issues as well. Delay in application or documentation problems, unforeseen buyer credit issues or last minute changes in buyer's credit. By the way, we're gonna talk about that last one a little bit more in just a moment. And also lender's failure to approve and lender's failure to fund.
The way to stay out in front of these issues is by selecting an originator who will get a buyer through a full underwriting process prior to home shopping. You can offer to assist buyers with paperwork or perhaps refer them to a credit counseling. You can have a buyer then reapply with corrections or perhaps have your buyer do parallel loan applications and definitely give the buyer some pre-closing credit warnings, which again, we'll cover in a minute.
What about other contingencies like the sale of the buyer's house, getting third-party approvals on short sales or distressed sale properties? Or what if the title report is clouded?
Sure, so take backup offerings on your listings. Know who to and how to communicate in complex transactions. Know what the timetable should be for such communications. And finally, be sure you get a preliminary title report on your listings and read them before going on the market. Sometimes there can be issues with co-op agent.
Right. So I hear plenty of complaints in the industry about co-op agents, but let's do our best to keep our own egos out of the negotiations, and let's make assumptions that at times co-op agents are simply less educated about the market. Perhaps they're unintentionally giving bad advice or service in the form of poor communication. Perhaps they have not attended to the details, or maybe they're making poor vendor selections. But we can stay out in front of this by clarifying our clients' intentions and our clients' messages. We can simply own the process and deliver sound communication throughout it. We can also provide backup options to our buyers and to our sellers.
The sixth common issue, and one that we must bulletproof, are deadlines. You might have a tight inspection or repair deadlines. Perhaps the closing date selected won't work. And we often see occupancy issues with taking possession, and certainly see delayed approval because of delayed documentation being delivered by the buyer to the lender. So in these cases, be sure to confirm inspection and appraisal appointments and follow up on their progress. Build in some buyer and seller flexibility up front. Let them know of common delay issues and have them prepared for this, and make sure to manage your closing checklist day to day, week to week, and hour by hour.
Agreed. So we both mentioned this thing about buyer credit issues and things for buyers to be wary of. Let's talk about the seven don'ts of mortgage funding that we educate our buyers on upfront and throughout the process. These are: number one, don't change employment status. Number two, don't make any major purchases like cars, furniture, vacations, etc. Number three, don't increase your credit card debt or miss any payments. Number four, don't change bank accounts or make undisclosed large deposits. Number five, don't apply for credit card, co-sign on a loan, or make any sort of credit inquiries. Number six, don't spend money you've set aside for closing. And number seven, don't delay providing all paperwork necessary that the mortgage company will need.
Remember to be proactive in the transaction, and this will keep everyone focused on the positive. Also, keep your clients intentional and flexible. Also, be an early responder. Focus on keeping awareness and accountability for all players in the transaction. Be a problem solver and be customer-centric in handling whatever goes wrong.
So that wraps up our shift series and the 11 tactics that the millionaire agents use to thrive in a shifted, or to thrive in any market for that matter. Successful people shift. They shift always, continuously and relentlessly. You cannot do all things at once, so focus on what's important first. Remember that we fail our way to success. Remember the serenity prayer. God grant me the serenity to accept the people I cannot change, the courage to change the one I can, and the wisdom to know it's me.
So feel free to visit our website, realestatecareersinutah.com, to sign up for our agent newsletter. You can also sign up for our business planning clinic there, or simply book a one-on-one appointment with our team and dive deeper with a valuable conversation about you and your business and how to thrive in a shifting market.